Now we have Mr. Ljupcho Trajkovski, the next presenter. The success factors.
Dobar den. Ime to mi je Ljupcho Trajkovski, dobar sam od Skopje. Imah tovo štastje da bih pokanet na predišnjite dva foruma. Много благодаря на организаторите и толкова се надявам дека ще има шанс за четвърто посещение. Окей. Success factor. We need something more than our capability to achieve not only results, but the benefit of our efforts. I will focus today on my special topic of digital transformation. To understand or to excuse me, I would like to say a few information about myself who are guiding my work today. I was graduated at the computer engineering faculty many, many years, somewhere in the middle of previous century. I was employed in a good company and after 1 year, I have opportunity to choose my career development, IT technology or IT management. And in this decision, I take in account advice of my father. Please understand and excuse me if it's a cruel. In your language, in my language, in the most languages of the world, there is a proverb, the fish smelled from the head, but we are cleaning from the bottom. An addition of my father was, if you are looking for money fast, clean the bottom. If you are looking for a future benefit, maybe it will be helped if you start to clean the head of the fish. Cleaning the head is a practically management consulting. In that moment, I start to work on a field. Today, it has a very modern name, and it was IT governance. Please, governance is not government. Risk and security and compliance, respecting the standards. Today, I am focused on a digital transformation process and more specific on the dark side. I believe that you know what means dark side of something. Currently, I'm engaged in a, for me, the biggest challenging project in Armenia, 3 years, implementing government interoperability platform where all citizens, 2 million people, 100,000 business units will use the services from the government. Challenge number one, regardless of the dark side. Where are we now? We can discuss, are we in digital age or we are not in the digital age, but in any case, we are not anymore in the industrial age. So we have to go ahead to reach today digital age, and this process is officially named digital transformation. How to fulfill the requirements to be citizen of the digital age. To look just at the first paragraph, what is the definition of digital transformation? Digital technology, new business processes, new organization, and people without attribute, new. People cannot be new or old. They have to be only existing people. So digital transformation, as we understand today, is focused on innovation, new technology, new organization, new business processes, but for using the benefit of all this, we need the last phase, people who will adopt this technology and achieve and fulfill their expectation. This part for me is not covered properly. Another interesting fact, disruption. I believe that in Bulgarian, disruption means identically as in Macedonia. Нарушаване, окей? Дали това позитивно или негативно? В Digital Transformation имаме друга дефиниция на Digital Disruption, така е написано тук. И тази дефиниция, and this definition sound much more positive than the first definition. In the first definition we have problem, we have disturbance. In the second definition we have no exception terms. For me it's a double moral. We must not forget digital transformation process has two actors. Digital service providers, vendors of services and technology, looking for good business. And we have a digital service consumers, citizens, businesses who are interested more in the benefits than in the aims. These two objectives are sometimes in conflict. In the last year, I saw many presentations for a digital transformation, for startups, for innovation, where the speaker used the final slide. Be disruptive. It means develop something that will destroy all competitors. Only few presenters, so-called type B advocates. But take care, don't disrupt people. What do you mean, don't disrupt people? Imagine my project in Armenia, new technology, new processes, and 120 civil servants with more than 20, 30 year experience. What kind of impact it is on them? So, in any case, digital disruption, it's official term, and if you look on the internet, you will find enough material, creates organizational and user change. So it's a fair, as much effort to be put in innovation, to put at least the same amount of work in helping organizations to adopt new solutions. I don't know, it's not possible to see the top, but this is so-called market law, who defined that technological innovation are going exponentially, organization and society is going logarithmically. And by time, this difference is bigger and bigger. This is from 1990. The chief executive officer from the General Electric, who was dying, and this gentleman helped General Electric to become again top company. And this is a statement applicable for our attitude to digital transformation and innovation. Very specifically, in what situation we are, especially country in development, not Scandinavia, but south of Europe. We have our situation. We invest in a project and big investment to reach the technological development line and start to use this new technology with an old organization. And of course, the results are not as they have to be. So it's our responsibility as a designers of the project to decide where is the optimal place, how to implement and innovate technology, taking in consideration the capability and absorption power of the society and the companies. Governance. I told in the beginning, governance is not government. The most simple definition of governance is there is no stakeholders. Everybody is shareholder. Everybody is owner. What means a good governance? This is an almost 200 years old statement of Abraham Lincoln. Government for the people, with people, by people. We have the same situation now. In a smart city, it will have a little bit more specific definition. Good governance, what it means. This is a picture from the business sector, but it's identical for the public sector. Who are the shareholders? Taxpayers, citizens, businesses. Taxpayers, businesses delegate the power for government to the political bodies. Political bodies are using controls to manage the society, but the shareholders are owners. They are looking, what is the benefit for us? And finally, these benefits from the owners and citizens are defined with objectives, but the government, with their controls, has objectives too. Are they objectives the same or not? For example, case from my country, from Anvik, Minister for Ecology, made a statement, we are not here for citizens, we are here for social aspects of the society. The question is, we have a steel plant who is ecologically terrible, not fulfilling the European regulation, and the option is to close and to put 3,000 people on the street, or to help the company to implement a new ecological standard. And I'm almost done. I believe that the word crowd means the same in Bulgarian and Macedonian. Tolpa is something positive or something negative? What was the tolpa in Paris two nights ago? 100 people on the Elysee fields. It's a crowd. Crowdsourcing is the official term in digital transformation, in all innovation management processes. It means collecting the ideas from the people. Crowding sourcing is not focus group. You are inviting 10 people and pay lunch to say we have a participation of the public. Wikipedia is a crowdsourcing, YouTube is a crowdsourcing, and they are a very rich source of new ideas. Good or bad, it's a next step. And this is the end. Sorry for yellow, but there if you cannot read. People, not technology, are key to digital transformation. And the second statement, we need a new advocate who will force prepare people to have benefit of digital disruption. It means every our program or project should have additional project phase preparing the beneficiaries to use the benefit and to understand the cost of innovation. And the very, very last slide, smart. What is the meaning of smart? The most probably you will say clever, wise, or smart with dot S dot M dot, you know, sample, measurable, blah, blah, blah. And I find one definition from India, and I believe that it will become very present from now on. Smart city must have smart citizen, and smart citizens like to be key actor in the smart governance. It means we need sample, iter, or component. M, we need moral society, moral government. We need accountable. By the way, accountable is a little bit different understanding in our languages. Officially, accountable means to be responsible for decisions, not for execution. For execution, we need responsibility. We need accountable decision makers, including crowds, responsive, not to have promises for the heaven, but to have promises for this mandate, and finally, transparent.